What is up, y'all? Hope y'all having a wonderful day. We are back here for part two in the back nine here at Cascata in Boulder City, Nevada, just outside of Las Vegas. This place is immaculate. This has been so much fun. Finished at 2 under par on the front side, so playing some good golf. The greens are really good, and I like fast greens. I typically putt better on them, so made one or two pretty good putts there on the front side to get us under par. Very happy with that. See if we can't take it low, shooting the 60s here at Cascata. We're gonna take you straight into number 10, par 4, 466, straight away down the hill. Our target aiming point is gonna be the far left bunker. That one pretty good. Maybe just down the right side, but I think it should be in pretty good shape. And that is what you love to see starting here on the back nine. We are right here, kind of right center of the fairway, 83 yards left, middle pin. I'm going with the 60 degree, try to kind of flight this in there, knock it close, get a little momentum going into the start of this back nine. Let's knock it close. That clean. That landed firm. These greens are a little firm. Shouldn't be too bad. Looks to be about 15 to 20 feet, just right. Alrighty, we landed right there. Fix that here in a second. It trundled all the way back there. These greens are firm, especially if you're coming out of the rough. Got about 20 feet putting back down the hill. Probably breaking a little from right to left. Would love to get the putter going here on the back nine. Let's go. I love these greens out here. It is fun when the putter starts heating up. Birdie here on 10. You love to see the early pin slammers. We're on to number 11, par 4, 346. Pretty straight. I'm gonna hit a little mini stinger up there. We are currently 3 under par, 1 under here on the back. 3 under on the day total. Great shape to post a great number here at Cascata. This course is absolutely immaculate, cut into the hills. Sometimes you kind of wonder how they even built a golf course out here because the terrain is insane, but so much fun. It's time to hit a stinger. Here's what we're facing with. We're gonna be aiming at the far right bunker there, playing a little fade off of it. Little stinger sauce right there. We're in perfect shape right here. 99 yards left. I've got lob wedge. It's playing a little uphill, so probably 105, but the greens are firm. I'm gonna go ahead and hit this full. I think it should be a good number. Left of the flag, but I think it should be on a pretty good number. You love to see when a number pans out perfectly. We are about 1 foot short of pin high, thankfully, because that pin is all the way back. Yes, that was a perfect number for that club. Landed right there. Firm greens, so it did hop forward slightly. No backspin hardly here today. However, 8-9 feet, putting back across the hill, slightly uphill, breaking a little left or right. Let's roll the rock, get 2 birds in a row. Would have loved another birdie, however, par here on 11.
We're on to number 12 here. Cool little par 3, 161 yards. You can see the pin set just over the corner of the bunker. Pretty much in the middle of the green. We're going with 9 iron.
That looks to be in great shape right there. Roughly pin high, just left of the flag. That would actually be right of the flag, not left. Yep.
I can blame TIG for all my rights and lefts getting messed up. It all started when me and TIG started filming. So yeah, TIG, I appreciate it. Very thankful that there hasn't been really much wind today. I am sure this course has some teeth when the wind is blowing. It really hasn't blown too much, maybe like 5 to 7 miles an hour at times, which can affect the ball a little bit, but it's almost no wind right now. So we're just kind of taking dead aim at all these flags. Got about 4.5, 5 feet left for another pin slammer. Let's roll the rock.
Let's go. Pin slammer here on 12.
Wanted to talk real quick about the scorecard. 71-37. This back nine is 3,648 yards, so it definitely has some length.
This is a Reese Jones design, and I'm a little caught off guard. There's a coyote up there
behind the bush. He said, I don't want to be on camera. You can kind of see him moving. There he is. There he is, the coyote.
I mean, these views, look at that. Yeah, incredible. Definitely recommend it if you're in the Vegas area looking for a pristine course to play just outside of town. Want to say thanks so much to Cascata for having me out here. We're on to number 13, par 4, 469, down the hill, dogleg left.
Definitely looks like we want to keep it left of those three bunkers. So our target aiming point is going to be somewhere right in there.
So he hit that one well, but that was a little left. I had to think about it right there. I almost said right. Yeah, well, our lefts and rights are getting all mixed up. I think that could be perfect, or I could be in a world of trouble. We're gonna have to go down there and see.
All right, so we were coming from somewhere like right in that direction, and here's where we ended up. I mean,
we were cutting it close. I don't know if I landed up there in the rocks. My recommendation, if you're playing those back boxes, don't cut off that much of the corner. Like I said, we could be perfect or we could be in a world of hurt. Thankfully, we're perfect. So yeah, 112 yards left down the hill. This green is set in kind of a cool little spot down here. I don't know, it just looks kind of cool. See if we can't knock this close, sand wedge in hand. Just a little right and a little pass. We got a birdie look. Looks to be about 15 to 20 feet. Would love to get another birdie right here. Like I said, 15 to 20 feet here, putting back down the hill. These greens really are some of the best greens that I've putted on in a very long time. They are very true and very quick. They're kind of speeding up as the day goes. These downhill putts can really get away from you if you're not careful. The tweeters are flowing today. Let's go.
This is the best my putter has felt in a very long time. I have not been making many putts outside of 7 or 8 feet. To see a few go in on this 18 here at Cascata has been really fun. And like I said, these greens are rolling so good. You just have to get it started on the line and be careful with pace, but wow, they hold their line. And if you get it started well, it's gonna go in.
Hey, little dude, just letting you know, we got it to 5 under par.
And they have waterfalls everywhere out here, I feel like. Super cool waterfall on the left side of the tee box here on 14. Down the hill, bends a little to the right, 434 yard par 4. Our target aiming point is gonna be right out in there.
All right, caught that a little spinning. That is down the right side. There's a little creek down there. I don't know. It's going to be pretty close.
All right, here's what I was talking about. This creek runs all the way down the side of the fairway. However, we are okay right here, just on the edge of the fairway. 116 yards left. Looks to be pretty much a middle pin.
It was hard for me to see over the corner. I couldn't see if it landed like in the creek or got over it. I got over it, thankfully. I'm gonna go with the sand wedge here. It's 116 yards, but not much wind and not really downhill from here. I think that's the club. Let's knock it close. That landed a little short right, but it did hop forward and should be on a pretty good number. We are currently 5 under par with 4 holes to play. We're on a number 15, slightly down the hill, 209 yard par 3. This is a good one. You've got some great views back behind the green there. And I've been very happy for the most part of how I've played on this trip. It's been some of my better golf in a while. Most nines have been under par, which is awesome seeing that trend going into the spring. But like I said, all in all, very happy. And when I get on good greens like these here at Cascata, I can make some putts. I love good, pure, fast greens. So let's see if we can't finish strong. I'm gonna go with a smooth 6-iron here. That might have been a little long right there, a little long left. So I did see that right. It landed right in there. Hopped, kind of a big hop right there. Trundled off the back edge. We're gonna be chipping kind of back down the hill from this angle. A lot of green to work with, but we want to get this rolling like a putt, probably breaking a little left to right. You hate to see them. That is the unfortunate bogey here on 15.
Chip was mediocre. It trundled out quite a bit. Probably had about 12 feet coming back and just slightly misread it. However, still in great shape. 4 under par, 3 holes to play. With spring golf upon us, if you're looking for some gear to look fresh out there, drop by my store, ostrich.com. Link will be down in the description down below. We've got quarter zip pullovers. Got hoodies, we've got polos, got tees, we've got hats. So a little bit of everything. Any support of Ostrich is supporting me and this channel, and it is all greatly appreciated. All the support so far has been unbelievable. So thank you all so much on number 16. All righty, we've got a par 5 here, 508 yards. Looks like the fairway sits off to the left, but this hole bends around to the right. Question is, how much do we want to take off? All right, so I'm looking up there. I thought it bent to the right. Before I teed up, I was glancing up there again, and I was like, this hole bends to the left. But I realized that because we may have been off in the desert where you definitely don't want to be. I'm not going to be cutting off any of that rock. I'm going to be aiming left. I'm going to be aiming almost on the left edge, the right edge of the left desert. That's our target aiming point. All right, down the right side, and apparently it slopes big time because that landed on the edge of the fairway, kind of hopped, trundled down to the left. Looks to be in great shape. Perfect shape right here. 208 yards left. Can see the flag whipping in the wind right there. I'm gonna go with the 6-iron.
Tough to see from here, but I saw it bounce, so I think that's a good sign. Looks to have landed up there. As long as it didn't take too big of a hop, should be in good shape.
All right, walking up here a little short. Thought it hopped up in there. However, not the worst place to be. Have a little green to work with. See if we can't chip it up there close.
That is another pin slammer here on 16. The bounce back bird, you love to see it. That gets us back to 5 under par with 2 holes to play. This hole is super sick. You've got this massive mountain here on the left, down the hill, couple bunkers down the right side. I think you want to cut the corner here because this is 489 yards from all the way back here. And I definitely think I want to be left of those bunkers. I think those bunkers are reachable. So we're going to be taking it over the corner. And this time I'm certain it does bend to the left, unlike the last hole that I almost got it completely reversed. That's in the past. And we corrected ourselves before we hit the tee shot. We're going to tee it high, let it fly right here.
Our target line is going to be somewhere right in there.
So that was pretty much ending up right at the left bunker. Couldn't tell if it trundled in there or not. We'll have to go find out.
All right, there is where we are. 175 yards left down the hill. Pin looks to be in the middle in the front, so pretty much a green light special.
Well, that wasn't very good. Should have taken my advice that I'm always telling everyone, take one extra club and swing smooth. Choke up just a little bit. What did I do there? I hit the 8 iron, which into the breeze was pretty much a full 8 iron. Might have slipped a little bit, but why in the world was I ever hitting an 8 iron? I should have choked up on a 7 iron, swung smooth, have tons of green behind that pin to work with. So learn from me, take that as a lesson. Don't do that. Take an extra club, choke up a little bit, swing smooth. We've got 86 yards left down the hill. We're gonna try to wedge this close. Might have needed to fly that just a few feet further. That one actually landed pretty soft, but we got a putt. When you like the greens, you like the greens. Even with that terrible bunker shot, we got out of here and saved par. Leaves us at 5 under. This putter has been the MVP today. It is feeling really good to make some putts. It really has been a little while. Putter stroke through the winter. Didn't feel very good and really wasn't sure what I was doing. Yeah, just all in all wasn't great. So today, huge confidence builder. Really feeling like I'm hitting some good putts, and it's easy to do on very good greens, but the confidence is coming back. So let's see if this is here to stay. And we are on to the final hole, number 18, par 5, 559 yards. Awesome looking finishing hole. Bunker down the right, bends to the left. I'm going to guess that the green sits off kind of back in there. So our target aiming line is going to be just inside that corner there. So when I was standing up there on the tee box, I decided to take it a little further left than my initial thought. However, now I'm a little nervous because I hit that really well, But that is cutting off a whole lot of that corner on a course I've never played. I don't know where that ball is going to end up. So I hope we chose a proper line. I hit it well, and the hole does bend that way. We're sure on that. Now that we're up here, I would have never taken that line. I was coming from somewhere in there. There's where my ball ended up. I guess it landed like right in there, kind of trundled up to here. I would not recommend playing it that way when you come play here. That is not the play at all. I would not hit driver. That's not the play. However, we're in perfect shape. 210 yards left, slightly down the hill, into the wind. I'm gonna go with a smooth 5-iron here because there's water short. You don't wanna be short. See if we can't end with an eagle putt. Well, it's not short. I landed on the back edge and hopped just over. Well, this has been so much fun. Hope y'all have enjoyed coming along. Drop a like down below. That would be greatly appreciated. That lets me know what kind of content you like to see here on the channel. And if you would like to continue seeing these traveling course vlogs, kind of seeing what scores I can shoot and some possible ideas for where to play when you're out traveling. So we are currently 5 under par. Here's where we ended up, just off the back, landed right there, hop forward a little bit. We're chipping back down the hill. This would be for 7 under. And I was trying to think. I believe in Nashville Golf, I finished at 8 under before from the blue tees. So this is from the tips out here. I don't know if I have finished 7 under or better from the tips on any course vlog I've ever done. I actually don't think I have. So this would be huge if I can get this to go in. Finish at 7 under 65. That would be so much fun to end this trip with that. Finish with a pin slammer here on the last. You absolutely love to see it. The birdies were flying here at Cascata. I love this course. This is an awesome course. Finished at 6 under. That is what I'm talking about. It has been a long time since I felt really good about the game, especially the putter. And we rolled the rock today. We rolled it well. These greens are pure. And if you get that ball started online, it's gonna go in. Ending with a birdie, ending on a good note. Love to see it. As for me, Cascata, Boulder City, Nevada. We'll see you when we see you. Peace.